Hey, how you doing out there in YouTube land? Welcome back to my channel, Verocity Trigger. We're going to be doing another Let's Play, Iscalio. Iscalio, we're going to play as Dryst. So we're going to come in here and we're going to do this. I have a whole bunch of challenges lined up for myself. Subscriber challenge, I have challenges from Valkos, and me and Valkos are doing a challenge at the same time. You know, that's going to be hard too. So this is going to be very difficult. So we'll get into this. We'll start a new game here. Not the multiplayer. Hopefully you're enjoying the multiplayer also that we're doing against each other, where we're beating down each other's monsters and knights and trying to win. So we're going to go for king like we always do. I always go for hard. This was called hard before, but now it's called king. So difficult challenge. King. So let's start it up. Let's see what this is all about. Got to go to Iscalio. And I'll get into the challenges as soon as we start the game up, you know, and talk about it. But Dryst is one of my favorite leaders. One of my favorites in this entire game of Brigandine. It's between Vinard and Dryst. It's always been between those two guys. So we're going to go with Dryst here. I'm going to play as this mad tyrant of a character. I don't think he's such a mad tyrant. I think he's misunderstood, and I think he's just extremely happy with his ability to do whatever he wants. But, I mean, it's said in here, you know, what it said, but it doesn't really say any, besides when he sends Ira on a quest to go get a feather. Other than that, I haven't seen anything that's super tyrannical about him. Haven't seen it. I don't know. He seems to like to joke a lot and like to play around a lot. But basically, I mean, you already know the story up there. I'll let you hear this though.
War covers the world. Even if all Fersenna burns to ash, I will fight on. Fight on like a demon. I will rule it all.
So, yeah, we'll get into it. There'll be a little bit of a cutscene. I'm going to probably pause the video a little bit, let you hear the cutscene. I'm going to raise the volume so it's really well heard. So people that have done the voice acting, which there has been voice acting added to this, not from Atlas. No, thank you, Atlas. You didn't do this. And not even the Japanese people. It's all, you know, done here. Everybody will see their names in the credits below. They watch for this whole playthrough. They'll get to see all that stuff too. So, at Calicent in Iscalio.
Your Majesty, General Zemeckis has rebelled and overthrown the Kingdom of Almechia in a single night. He's founded the Ascaris Empire. Now, he's declared himself the first emperor.
Zemeckis and his muscle brain finally did it. Good for him.
Your Highness, this is chaos. The kingdom must act with caution.
You fool! This is no time to start worrying about something someone else started. It's time to start something ourselves. Even a fool understands something that simple.
But that's so reckless.
You fool! Time to show all the puny knights across Fersenna how pathetic they are compared to me. Splendid idea, Your Majesty. A perfect time for you to take over the world. What a suck-up. But Your Majesty, we share borders with Leone, Caerleon, and Ascaris. We fight all three at once. We'll be destroyed. I recommend we ally with one so that we can focus on fighting the other two. Hmm? Are you suggesting I lower myself to the level of another country and fight besides them? Pooh, I don't need help. I could crush Ascaris and anyone else single-handed. Ready, Ira?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Ooh, what will become of Iscalio? So, that's pretty much the precept as to what Iscalio is like. Now, I've been looking around, you know, seeing what people say about Iscalio, what people think about Iscalio. He's the Mad King Dryst, this and that, the other thing. He likes to have fun, but he hasn't started major war before this because there is chaos now. Because there is chaos now, there's just going to be chaos. You know, people are going to attack all over the place. And he knows that that's what's going to happen, so he's going to have to go out and fight. Could he ally with one of these? Maybe. But the chances of him actually becoming their ally is very slim. This is a holy country. He's not exactly that holy. This one is maybe Caerleon. He might have been able to ally with Caerleon. But as far as the game is concerned, you really can't have him ally with almost anybody because, oh man, you gotta have a country that's very hard to work with and very hard to use. And this is that country. If you want to play as, you know, if you want to play Brigandine, you want to play one of the hardest countries to start as, this is your country to start with. Some people can look at him like, I've even seen a comment. I don't know where I saw this comment, but I was reading this. And I was like, wow. You know who Dryst resembles the most as far as this comment was concerned? President Trump. Well, if that's the case, let's make Brigandine great again. Because I'm going to right now. I'm going to use the Mad Monarch and make Brigandine great again. And that's what we're going to do. So, here's the thing. I wanted to get into some of these things and talk about this before we go any bit further. And I'm not going to show the whole organization phase. There's just too much to do. I can't really think and talk about it at the same time. I mean, maybe I might be able to move a few things around, but what I wanted to basically say was there's three things that we're going to be doing on this channel. You, the viewer, Valkos, and Valkos and I are going to also work on something too. So, first thing to start for you, viewer, is that I'm going to be taking a special team to fight Bullnoil. Now, that team I'm going to pick, but I want you to pick the team for me that's going to go and fight the Snake of Chaos. Now, if you want to make it challenging, go ahead. It's got to be something that I can acquire if it's like the last country that I have to attack and I cannot, you know, capture this knight from them. Well, then I can't really do anything about it. I can't get the knight because as soon as I beat them, I go into the Bullnoil fight, and right after that, it's a Snake of Chaos fight. So this has to be something that I can definitely acquire as far as knights are concerned. So if it's not a knight that I have, try to judge it based upon what I could possibly get, you know, what's good. Now, I have had a previous suggestion for one of the teams to be the Rand family, which is Miguel, Liguel, and Castor. And so I do have Miguel here, wherever the hell Miguel is. I think he's up here, and I think we just looked over him right here and asked. I think he's, yeah, Miguel's here. So I have to go and get, Lucia and Cat, or not Lucia, but Liguel and Castor, you know, because that's one of the picks. So I'm going to try to do that, but whether that happens or not, still definitely pick. So now is your chance right now to pick out of all the knights that I have, which ones are going to go into the Snake of Chaos fight. Could be Daffy, could be Victoria, whatever you're thinking. I would prefer a physical fighting team. That would make things kind of interesting. It's a lot of fun to take a physical fighting team in there. I mean, a wizard team can do very well too, but a physical fighting team is a little more challenging, and I kind of like to do that. So it could be Bagdemagus, maybe. Gallo would be kind of cool to see. I don't know, anybody you'd like to see. But I'll tell you the team right now that I'm taking to fight Bullnoil. Dryst, Ira, and Lucia. So Lucia is coming with me. The reason why is because I want a little bit of variety here. So I have red, blue, and green as far as my elements are concerned. Because I'm going to keep her as a scout and I'm going to do that sort of thing. And I'm going to take certain particular monsters for the Snake of Chaos fight. And certain kinds of monsters for the Bullnoil fight. You're going to be surprised. You're going to be amazed as to what I'm going to do and how I'm going to be Bullnoil. And how nuts it's going to be. It's going to be so easy. I will destroy him. So that's the thing for Bullnoil. I've got that covered. You have to pick my Snake of Chaos team. Okay, so that's part one. Part two is the challenges that I'm taking with Valkos. One of the challenges that Valkos gave me right now for this first LP was to use my pixies and only use the spell Dumb, which was silent before in the original. Now it's called Dumb. And I can't use Harden, which was Protect. So all I can do is Dumb on the enemy. So I have to find something to use for the next couple battles. I have to organize these stupid pixies to, you know, use the spell Dumb. And stuff like that. So, well, I do have this one here. I could probably just use this one. But yeah, definitely, that's part two of the personal challenge per video. So each video we're going to be given throwing challenges back and forth to each other. The other part is that me and Valkos made sort of a long-term challenge. This is going to be a very challenging thing all the way throughout the game. It is basically, the challenge is called You Only Live Twice. Now, if you ever played any 007 Bond game, you ever played the scenario You Only Live Twice, that's exactly what it is. You die once, you come back. The second death, you don't come back. So, if any one of these leaders gets KO'd, injured in battle, we have to rack that up to 1 point. And you guys can, like, watch that and follow along and be like, okay, Ulster died once. If he dies again, you cannot use him for the rest of the game. That's how we're going to do it. So, that's how me and Valkos are doing it. And it's going to be a little bit challenging, because if we get everybody KO'd, we could literally just not finish the LP. So, that's going to be quite, quite hard. So, I pretty much explained all of the things that are going on. Basically, what you, the viewer, right there, you watching me right now, what you got to do is you got to look at mostly either my knights or the knights that you think I could acquire. If you think it's like a Caerleon team, you know, let's say it's Bilcock, you'd be like, well, use Bilcock in a final fight. Well, then I got to go after Caerleon first. You know, and that sort of thing. Or if it's the Empire and it's something like Rayocord or Fiel, whichever one comes on your team, then I have to go after the Empire, conquer them, get it. So definitely vote at least three knights. Hopefully you vote three knights. Some people vote one knight, but definitely try to vote three knights so I have a good juicy list of knights I can use. You know, so I can tally it all up and say, okay, well, this knight has so many picks, boom, they're going into Snake of Chaos fight, and that sort of thing. So I think I've explained it enough. I'm going to go and organize everything because it's going to take me a little bit of time to come up with a decent team that I want for each of these. Basically, I'm going to go with Drist's main team right off the bat. And for my secondary defense team, I'm just going to use the best knights of whatever I have. And we'll go from there. And so I'm going to basically jump you right into the first battle or right before the first battle. So see you in a minute. A whole lot of attackers and no healers at all. So we're going to do this battle against Kai. We're probably going to lose some stuff, but it's going to be a lot of fun. I have two healers on this team. Ulster's nowhere to be found. He's still waiting back here. Not doing anything with Yura, just hanging around. I've got Daffy ordering some unicorns because that's really the only place I can get them. So let's see what happens here. Let's see what's going to happen here. Maybe we'll get to attack first. Hopefully we will. Let's see. Did you change anything? Oh gosh. This is going to be interesting. This is going to be fun. And it's going to be very brutal. Okay, so they moved a few things over there, but let's see. Can I attack you from here? I might be able to. That's a lot of ghouls. That is a buttload of ghouls. All right, so what about the queen? Does she have anything serious there? That's going to be a little problematic. I don't have enough people to cleanse stone. Yeah, that could be a little rough. I don't want to try that at the moment. I'm already trying something really difficult as is, and I can't lose my leaders at all. So whatever you got, Kai, I'm going to probably lose. This is going to be so hard. Oh, and I can't lose my leaders either. Okay, I'm going to have to find a way through this. I got to do something. Let's try it out. There we go. Going into this battle. You know what the armies consist of? I'm going to put you right into the main meat and potatoes of the fight, so enjoy. Okay, well, looks like they started the battle with me. Little ghoul on a dragon. Dinadan isn't in the fight, though, so that's a little disappointing. Dinadan is not here to do battle with me. I have nobody to heal myself, so this is going to be really interesting to see how I can handle this. Usually I have some healers with me. Usually I try to do that. Let's see where Kai goes. Where are you going to go, Kai? Right there? All right. Well, if you don't take anybody to block him, he's pretty much as good as dead. That I can guarantee you right now, right this minute. That could be a saving grace. We'll see. All right. Nope. Okay. He's blocked himself pretty good. This is going to be a... Look at that. I missed twice. I missed two different times. All right. Oh boy, this is going to hurt. This is going to hurt. Can I kill these three things off right away? I don't know. I could put the hurt on Kai immediately. Let's see here. Well, I can't protect him, but I can silence. I'm gonna get surrounded and killed, though. That's gonna hurt. Okay, so where's the strategy gonna come from? How am I gonna handle this? A breath attack through here can knock them down, knock them out. Move on in here. Probably this is the most powerful thing to do at the moment. Need to get this thing out of the way. Probably gonna lose a lot of stuff. Hopefully I don't lose the entire battle, but we'll find out. This thing's too high, doing too much damage. There we go. Gotta get him here, do something. This out of the way. All I can really use dumb, so I'll set him out there to start doing it, you know? I want to set her up for something, but there's also more to fight here. This thing is really powerful. We can get Alvarion out of the way. Maybe we'll kill him off completely. Might be a good thing for me to do. Kai, I want to get him super low, and I want to kill him off immediately if I can. That would be so good to do. This is actually a pretty good spot. I can breath attack Kai from here, actually. Can I do it twice, though? I think, yeah, I can do it twice. Why don't we start with a breath attack in case Kai decides to stay and do something really stupid. In case there's something really good to happen out of this. I don't know. I cannot tell you one bit whether that will work out all the way or not. Gotta trap him in here. I don't want to lower my ghouls down right now. I know the ghouls will do some damage, that is for sure, but I don't want to get them low. He is weaker to magic, but I don't know, man. I think we'll just stick with this for now. Save my magic for something serious. In case something serious comes along. I do have more turns to happen, you know. Well, the ghoul will probably die. I'm probably going to lose a lot of stuff, believe it or not. If Dinadan comes out the front lines, that'll change my perspective as to how I'm going to battle this. Which he might. He might do that. I don't know. Oh, you better not crit me. You already made me miss like twice in a row with two different demon attacks. Neither of the demons did anything. They couldn't do anything. That really sucked for me. Seriously, that was terrible. That was absolutely terrible. Alright, so we need to... I can't even work on that thing right now. Cannot. Alright, so to try to make this a little more strategic in a way that I can kill this thing off, still move up and move around, I'm going to have to do it like this. Move in here. Is that enough? Could she do it with that? Come on, you've been critical attacking me so much. Come on, get 71, please. Come on, Lucia. 83, thank you. Oh, that was great. Well, I got dumb. That's all I can do is dumb. Yep. Not gonna work, dude. Definitely not going to work. Look at how many criticals they had on me. This is unbelievable. Dryst literally gets just shafted. He really does. I never thought about it. Misses. They get crits. Oh my gosh. Did you just go right there? Oh, dude, Dinadan, that was the worst thing you could do. It's got to be the worst thing you could do. You did not just go right there. I don't believe it for one freaking second. No. No. Just no. And another crit! And another crit. See, this is why Dryst is so pissed off. Look at this. Wow. 145, nice job. Oh, they killed off her. She was too low. She was too low. She was just too low. I would have used that curse. I would have just smashed Dryst. I would have smashed Dinadan's face in. Well, I used what I had to use. I did it right, you know. All right, we gotta just hope for one. Honestly. He's only at 15. Ooh, do I have a plan? Oh, do I have a plan? Oh, yes. This is going to be beautiful. You guys are going to appreciate this one. Nope, at 63. We have to go with what we can work with, you know? Oh, he can't even move in there yet. Twelve. Good job, Dinadan. Good job. Can I kill this thing off with him? That'd be awesome if I could. I don't know if I can, though. Oh, just 88. Kind of need to. Kind of need to, though. things. I am going to go to town on you, dude. Ho, you are not going to like this. And because he is stunned, I have to go with a flame attack. I was going to go wail on him with a big physical ranged attack, but this is even better. So now he doesn't come out of that. Not right now. Not at all. Alright, so we lost a couple interesting things. Ooh, he's level 9. Can he even get out? He can't be saved. I cannot save him. Oh, I lost my little ghoul. I lost little ghoul, man. I lost him. It's so sad. Okay, alright, let's get on with this. Let's kill off Dendadan. Let's not wait forever. Goodbye. Since I don't have any healers, I have to really worry, you know, watch what I'm gonna actually hit here. So we're gonna have to just kind of play it like this, you know? Can I go whack on Kai a little bit? Get close? I don't want her getting nailed anymore. I don't know if she's really gonna get hurt too much though. Besides this dragon, I don't really know what can hit her. What to do? Alright, let's curse this thing and then let's use the dragon to come over here and hit it a little bit. And my centaur will kill off that other. Yeah, that should work. Man, they were giving him like critical attacks, and I was getting misses immediately. This is gonna look really ridiculous. Yeah, why not? Make him think about his options here, because if he's like, no, I'm gonna stay, blah, 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 boom, you're gone, man. You are gone. You know what would be hilarious? Would be hilarious if this even had a percentage of working. That would be hilarious. Alright, well, I got his dumb, so let's make somebody dumb, even though it ain't gonna do anything. There you go, Valkos. I did it. There's the dumb. I have to do it one more battle. I wish I could get out of this scot-free, but I can't. It sucks. Did I hit anybody to kill him? No. Oh, let's just wait. Whatever. Yeah, go ahead, kill him. I don't care. Ooh, the trident. I wasn't thinking about that. And I had another miss on my team. Yeah, Dryst's team starts off very, very crappy. Dryst and the Balmot and Ira have the best evasion in the game, bar none. But all the rest of their monsters suck balls. They just suck. They seriously suck terribly bad. And I hate it. I really, really do. I wish there was something I could do to change that factor, but there's not much I can do. Okay, enough complaining. Let's go kill something. Can I shoot Kai? Can I kill Kai? That's the problem. What's the remedy? What's the answer here? Doesn't look like I'm going to be able to. Unless he can get around all the way. I might. If I could kill Kai, that would be great. Let's just try it. Let's try it. I don't know if I can. Because I want Lucia to get the final kill, but I don't know if it's going to happen. I don't think it can happen, actually. I think the only way to kill Kai is not going for Lucia to get the final kill. I think that's really all there is. Because I have to have the other one in the blue to be able to do a shot. Here we go. Okay, Kai, can you stay in this battle and stick around? Play with my army a little bit. That'd be cool. Aww. I'm gonna lose him. Okay, okay. we're gonna go with you. Doesn't matter. I gotta tag team him. 95. 62. Give me your high centaur. I really want that high centaur, dude. Give me that high centaur, Kai. I want it. I want it bad. Fighting on would be irrational. We must withdraw. Boom, 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 boom. Level 7. That's what I wanted. Here we go. First battle over. Done and over. Valkos, I completed part 1 of your challenge. The little mini challenge. Little tiny mini challenge. Let's see what I got. I'm going to need some unicorns. I'm going to have to come back and grab some unicorns. Unless because I quested Daffy with unicorns. If he comes back now, that'd be great. Ooh, new Omeki attacked. Ooh, ooh, look at this, look at this. They bit the dust. Teeth quests, where'd you go, teeth? Did you find a little gnome to give you a mushroom? Did you pass out because of that? Well, you better be careful who you trust. So, okay, so that was that. Oh, he's got a little... Oh, cool. What can I get here? Angels! Ooh, I'm gonna need an angel, probably. Gonna need an angel. Quest knights? For only live twice? Don't. That doesn't count. So, sorry. If you're looking forward to that, doesn't count. So what can I get? I should probably definitely get an angel for this. She went up pretty good. And I cannot class her in anything else. See, I can't class any of these guys. Not until she becomes level 10. Then I could class her into something. I should definitely get that angel though. I have enough for it. Let's do it. I'm gonna need some healers since I have no healers at all. I went to that just going just balls to the wall. You know, no healers at all. Like, yeah, man, I can do it. It's okay. I can clear it. As long as Dinadan or Kai comes out to a stupid area and does something really stupid, I can just smash him in the face, which is what we did. So, what we got here? Nothing great yet. Nothing great at all. Ironically, I was watching Valkos' channel, and Teeth got injured in the battle. First battle. So, is this karma? Is this like cosmic karma? You know, Teeth also gets injured here too, but not the same way. Because we did talk about that. So, quest knights coming back doesn't count. It's battle knights being injured or wounded that count against that. Because, you know, you can't do anything... Questing is not a challenge. There's no challenge in it. It's not, you know, it just gives you maybe an extra item, maybe an extra knight. It's more of a gamble. Questing is basically gambling. You can't, it has nothing to do with your own personal strategy, so. Well, I beat down Kai. That was fun. Yeah, that was pretty cool. I don't know if I should continue. I don't think I can. I don't have any more... I don't have anything else I can do. I can't do anything else with this team here. Maybe I should go with Miguel. With them as... I'll have to think about this and think about how I want to organize, because I do want some healers here now that it comes to my mind. And I'm thinking about it a lot. I don't know who to do, though. Guessing maybe... Maybe I'll take Gallo with the other two healers and put Bagdemagus and Camden and Miguel together. I don't like how it looks. I'll have to think about this for a while and I'll have to come back to it. Yeah, we'll have to see. So we'll come back to that. I'm gonna have to wait a turn or so. I'll probably get attacked. Maybe on my defense, you'll get to see another pixie. Do its little silent, which does nothing for me at all. Thank you, Valkos, very much for your very difficult and ridiculous challenge that I hate beyond belief. I gave you a very easy challenge, man. Very easy challenge. Last LP, which you're completing now. So, name everybody a certain rock star. That was pretty simple. You gave me one and I... This helps me no way. You know this is very difficult to do. Because it's like, I have to bring one along. Just to do it. Just to annoy myself. So, okay. We'll get into the next one. No more complaining. Let's go on and let's wreck some face. Because I'm attacking Hadrian. So they don't attack me while I'm moving around. So, we'll see. I'm attacking with my other secondary team for right now. Hopefully they won't. Okay, so they did attack me. I didn't think they would. They only had like two knights up there and a knight over there. So it's going to be a very, very powerful force here, I'd say. The only problem with it is, though, good luck getting me off that castle. I'm going to move out with myself a little bit, but ain't going to be fun for them. Let's crunch them, Gallo. You got it. Charge. So, what you're probably wondering is, how am I going to handle this fight? Got a lot of meaty stuff here. They are both going in a row pretty fast, so I don't know if I can ambush the one on the left. Okay, so he's basically going to be a jerk and stay away from me and not come right up to me. Here's the crit miss again. It's coming to play. It's coming into play. A lot of his... another crit. Look at this. So, she's moving out. You know, I don't think I'll be able to hit her. Yeah, she'll be blocked off pretty good. If... another crit. I thought it was going to be another crit miss. Another crit. Another miss. Oh, man. Where to go here, though? Okay, so now I got a couple options. She just went... this idiot's going to go here pretty soon. Nothing can really hit me except for maybe the... not a single thing from that can hit me at all. So, I do have some options here. Can I move up there and hit her in any way, shape, or form? I don't think I can. Might be able to stone her. I can push through. I can power up that... no, I can't power up that attack there. I could do some damage to her, actually. That wouldn't be so bad. Oh, man. If I can hit this griffin, then I could knock it out and start wailing on her. But then he's got to come out. He wanted to be a big dink and just go two spaces. He could have came up here and attacked my man-eater. Or my mandrake, but he was like, nope, two spaces, I'm done. Alright, so that's pretty meaty. If I get rid of her, that could help me out a little bit. But I have to get rid of her. Since all I got is this dumb spell. Thanks, Valkos. This was so nice of you. Dumb would work on it, but it doesn't. Let's try it. 8%. I'll give it a shot. Well, I did it. I completed your challenge, Valkos. Are you happy now? I hope you're happy. Because I know I'm not. Hey, I hit the stupid thing. Nice. Great. Good job, Onyx. Really appreciate that, man. Appreciate that very, very much. Kind of have to clear the path here, you know. Alright, dude, come on back to Magus. We're coming in here. We're gonna take a little. This thing's gonna take a little beating. That was nice. A one shot? Thank you, man. Let's see, where are all my ones? Oh, gosh. I don't know where he can go. Well, he really can't go any further. It doesn't. Well, that is 100 points. 100 points is 100 points. So, I guess we'll go that way. They have no healing over there. Spit will be just fine. Come on, paralyze this idiot. There we go. Oh man, no, we didn't paralyze him. I thought for sure that was gonna be a paralyze. Oh really? That's it? I have to move him? See, this is why you guys did this. You guys are very intelligent on this part. I commend you for it. I will commend you for it. But I have to move everything like this. I don't have a choice. I have no dumb spell at all, so... because I have to move him into the blue, so I get enough attacks on her. I just have to do it like that. I don't have a choice. Alright, well, if I am going to get a hit, I'd rather it be with the dog. Oh, yes! Nice! Very nicely done. I am really digging this a lot. 98. Freaking 98%, and I totally biffed it. Can you believe this? Garbage. Garbage percentage of that. That is unprecedented. That's even a word. That is ridiculous. Okay, dummy. Come on down here, Railcord. Okay, you're done. Let's go finish this off here. I think he's too far down to even get to her. Yeah, just a little bit. Just a bit outside. Can you even get there? That would be perfect if you could. Can you get there? The game is trolling me right now. The game is freaking trolling. This is ridiculous. The game should not troll me like this. This is ridiculous. Come on. 98% and an 84? That is just stupid. That is just ridiculously stupid. Come on, I need my centaur to get a shot. And you should have been the other side. Okay. Dash is going to have to finish this off. Better not give me a bad 68%. 68% with a wyvern. Yeah, you better go home. You tell Vinard what you saw here. Yeah, get out of here. Goodbye. That's what I thought. Alright, well, let's level up back to Magus here. Well, I can't do... I already completed your challenge, Valkos, and there's nobody for me to cast... There's no one for me to cast Dumb on right now, so I'm just going to throw Harden on just because there's nothing left. They're going to run away the very next turn anyways, so I am not going to play that, you know. I already completed the challenge. I need to get some experience. I really do. All right, so let's go here. Ooh, that one I could use. That Djinn I could use. That'd be cool. All right, so Valkos' challenge is completed. I didn't totally lose anybody yet. As far as, man, the misses are ridiculous. You'll be watching my multiplayer. You watch my multiplayer and watch how many times I've missed with Dryst and how many times they crit attack me as Dryst. You'll be so surprised. You'll be so surprised. You'll be like, how did you get this far and how are you still alive? So, yep. Does that do anything? Nope. Alright, so... what is that? Back to Magus? Yeah, he's gonna get beat on a little bit. But it should be kind of okay. What can kill this thing? Fury to... Should level up this thing, though? Oh, let's level up the Clay Golem. Gonna need some frontliners to defend. Might as well. Let's see how much it can do. 225? Cool. I don't really want him getting nailed. I don't think I have a choice. Oh, I'm gonna lose tons of monsters if I don't. Oh boy. Who to heal up? Frontline. I really would rather get some dragons and stuff, but I gotta work on my teams. It's gonna be really hard to get Iscalio working. I'm gonna have to do some back and forth battles like this for a while till I can actually, you know, get something working for me. So I don't really know how I'm gonna set this all up for right now, but definitely this is gonna have to do it, everybody. So thanks a lot for watching all the way through this. You know, I'm gonna show you the map afterwards to show you where we've gone, this and that. Another critical. I'm just not getting hardly any criticals out of this. I'm taking the basic starting team. The basic starting team from Dryst is very rough. Very rough to work with. So, I completed Valkos' challenge. I did dumb on the enemy every time I had the chance to. Pixie in the back couldn't put dumb on anybody. I could send her out to do an attack, but this very next turn, they're gone. So that's pretty much it. So just to get some experience, I threw an extra protect on just so I could get some experience out of it, because otherwise I'm wasting my time. And yep, completed Valkos' challenge. Nobody died yet. We're looking pretty good here. Everybody leveled up. I got everything leveled up the way I wanted. It's pretty much a good thing I didn't get to attack Leoness, because the Umpire was coming in. So it's kind of good I didn't get to. Let's look at the map here. See where we're at. This is going to change. I'm going to have to come back here, reorganize, get more monsters. I'm going to have to go back and forth for a while until I have a third strong team, because Dryst only starts with two teams. You don't have enough monsters to make three. Your third team could be something really terrible, which you could, but then if you're playing on hard, well, it's going to get creeped. So that's the thing. So basically I got to make whole nother team. I don't know how I'm gonna work these other teams, but the whole point is everybody start to vote for the three knights that are gonna go and fight the Snake of Chaos. Ouroboros, Jormungandr, whatever you want to call it, Serpent of Chaos, I don't care. Vote for the three knights that are gonna go to that battle. That is your duty here to help play along with this let's play. That's what it means, let's play. So I guess that's what it means. I think that's what it means. Maybe there is no meaning to it. I don't know. Maybe somebody let me know what it means. But we're going to go through it together anyways. We're gonna crush everything. I don't know how Valkos is going to do this. I've seen him take a very weak team against this, and I think he came out alive, but I don't know what Valkos' plans are. But Valkos for the next challenge... did I give you the challenge already? What's your challenge, Valkos? Let me think here. Oh, yeah, Valkos, for your challenge for the next time, next battle, is that you have to not use any spells with Dryst. You have to use Dryst, and you can't use any spells. When you use Dryst, no spells for Dryst. Dryst has to go and use his scythe and cut through everything. So that's your challenge, Valkos. But anyways, thanks a lot for watching all the way through this. Yeah. I'm thinking I'm going after Kai. That's my idea, but we'll see. This is gonna be crazy. So definitely keep voting, and stay tuned for the next video. If you like to give us some likes, subscribe, share, all that stuff, and see you later.